There's nothing I love more than getting away from the classroom and escaping to the country. The fresh mountain air, the beautiful sounds of nature, it's so invigorating. The holidays are so close. Excuse me. Today, I'm going to show you how to create this beautiful mountain landscape using Google Drawings. Along the way, we are going to cover 5 important design skills. Let's get started. This is Google Drawings, and this checkerboard section here is our canvas. The first thing we are going to do is name our document something relevant, like mountain landscape. Like all programs in the Google Docs range, Google Drawings are automatically saved in your G Drive. The next thing we will do is change the size of our canvas to make it a little more panoramic. To do this, select File and scroll down to Page Setup. Let's change the canvas ratio to 16 by 10 to get a nice wide scene. The first skill we are going to learn about today is filling objects with gradients. Notice how the sky in our finished landscape changes from purple to orange. This is called a gradient fill, where one color changes to another. To apply a gradient to our background, let's right-click on our canvas and select Background. Select Gradient at the top of the pop-out menu, and then choose the little plus button below Custom. This will open our custom gradient panel. The two squares on each side of this line represent the two colors that our gradient will change between. Select the square on the left and choose a color from the drop-down menu with the little circle. We are going to choose this dark purple for the top of our gradient. Select the square at the other end of the gradient line and choose a bright orange color. Now our gradient is starting to look a lot more like a sunset. Next, select Add below Gradient Stop to add a small circle to our gradient line. This Gradient Stop circle allows you to control where the transition of our gradient sits. Drag to the right, and it's more purple. Drag to the left, and it's a little more orange. Leave the circle fairly close to the purple side, so our sunset will peak above the mountains. Select OK. Wow, looking great so far. Next, select View, Zoom, 50% to zoom out from our canvas. This will make our next step a little easier. The next skill I'm going to show you is adding fillable shapes using the polyline tool. Select the little down arrow next to the line in the toolbar and select Polyline. The polyline tool allows you to create closed shapes which can then be filled with a color and have a stroke around the outside. We're going to be using this a lot in our design. The first thing we are going to draw is our very back mountain. Start on the left side of the canvas, about 2/3 of the way up. Click, move, and click to create the points of your mountain across the page. When you reach the other side of the canvas, move down to create another point just outside the bottom right-hand corner. Then, come all the way across to the left-hand corner and create another point. And finally, close off your shape by selecting the starting point. If you've done it right, your shape should fill with a light blue color and have a black outline. Now, if you're sitting there wondering, why has he gone outside the canvas? Don't worry, I'll explain why in just a minute. Select the pencil stroke tool on the toolbar and select Transparent. This will get rid of our black outline. Next, select the Paint Bucket Fill tool and select the little plus button below Custom to make a custom color. Drag the hue slider across towards purple, then select a dark purple color for your back mountain. Now, let's repeat the process for the next mountain, starting a little lower than the first mountain. Again, make the stroke transparent and select the same fill color that you chose for the previous mountain. Now, select the Paint Bucket Fill tool and the plus button below Custom. Drag the color slider slightly down and to the right to create a darker shade of purple. Let's now have a quick look at how our artwork will look when printed or exported. Select File, Print Settings and Preview. Notice how everything outside your canvas has been cut off when printed. This is why it didn't matter that we went outside the canvas with our mountains. Select Close Preview to return to your artwork. Okay, let's fast forward a little as we repeat the same process for creating the next two mountains. Don't forget to turn the stroke to transparent and make the mountains a little darker each time. Also notice that the mountains flatten out a little as they move toward the front. Let's zoom back into our artwork using View, Zoom, Fit. Now, if you are unhappy with how any of your mountains look, simply double-click the shape and move the little blue anchor points around. Select the arrow icon or press Escape to deselect the shape. Let's zoom back out again to 50% so we have a little more room to make some trees. We are going to use the Polyline tool again to create a rough triangular trunk shape. Again, make our pencil stroke transparent and make the fill color the same as your front mountain. Use the Polyline tool to create another jagged shape about 1/4 of the way up your trunk, almost like bird wings. This shape will form the body of our tree. The next skill I'm going to show you is used all the time by designers to save time. It's called duplicating. Use the arrow tool to select your leaves. Right-click the shape and select Copy. Right-click again and select Paste. You can also use the keyboard shortcuts Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to save even more time. Now that we have duplicated our leaves section, we can resize it and position it on our tree. Right-click again and select Paste to produce another section of leaves, and repeat. You can also right-click certain sections of the leaves and select Rotate, Flip Horizontally. This will stop every section of the tree looking identical. Let's fast forward a little. Next, click and drag a box over your entire tree. Right-click and select Group. Grouping is another important design skill that allows you to build objects separately and then join them together. Resize your tree by dragging from one of the corners. Make sure to hold down Shift as you resize, otherwise your tree will lose its shape. Now, we are going to use our duplicating trick to make a forest. Right-click and copy, right-click and paste to produce a number of trees. Resize them from the corner, holding Shift, and move them around a little. You can also flip a few trees horizontally to keep things looking interesting. Once you've made a collection of trees and you are happy with the size and position, drag a box around them and group them. Now, drag them onto your canvas and resize them until you are happy. You might insert a few bigger trees and rotate them using the top anchor point to create the impression they are creeping in from the side. Repeat this process of grouping, resizing, and placing your trees until you are happy with your composition. The last thing we need to add to our scene is a setting sun. To do this, select the oval shape from the shape toolbar. Whilst holding shift, click and drag to create a perfect circle. Again, make sure the pencil stroke of our sun is transparent. As we did with our background, select the paint bucket tool and select gradient. This time, however, we want to change our gradient type from linear to radial using the drop-down menu. Select the square on the far left of our gradient line and choose a light yellow color. Then, choose the square on the far right and choose a bright orange color. Select OK. The last design skill I want to teach you today is called layering. You'll notice that when we move our sun onto our canvas, that it's in front of our mountains. Now, that's not going to work. Right-click our sun shape and select Order, Send to Back. This will send our sun behind the mountains, but in front of our background. And there we go. The last thing to do is to have a look at our artwork by selecting File, Print Settings, and Preview. Check this out. Isn't it beautiful? Today, I've shown you a bunch of new design skills that will hopefully help you with your own creations in Google Drawings. We've covered using gradient fills to create visual interest, using the polyline tool to produce different shapes, using copy and paste to duplicate objects, using grouping to keep our shapes together, and finally, using layering to reorder elements of our design. We'd love to see what you create using these skills. Make sure to reach out via social media at TeachWonderful to share your awesome artworks. We'll see you next time. Hey there. If you like what we do here at TeachWonderful, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You'll also find plenty of amazing teaching ideas, student worksheets, and merch over at teachwonderful.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.